Aside from freedom and a peace of mind, there's a lot of benefits from moving out of your parents' house that you probably haven't thought of yet. And if you're anything like me, this is probably something you've been thinking about very eagerly to the point where you're ready to rush time and get up out of there. You're probably imagining being able to do what you want, staying out as long as you want, and walking around the house naked. And if you say you ain't looking forward to that, you're lying. And that's all fine and dandy, but what you really get out of moving out of your parents' house and living on your own is what nobody really talks about. So I'm going to share my experiences with you in this video to give you some perspective, to help you understand why it's extremely important for you to move out of your parents' house as soon as you can. I couldn't wait to get out. I felt like I was a caged animal, like I was in jail or something, because I just felt like I could already handle everything. Like I could take on the world, and I just couldn't understand why I was getting lectured about the most menial things despite doing everything I was supposed to do. I wanted independence. That's what I said I wanted until I actually got it and realized that I didn't have the slightest clue what independence actually meant. Those constant reminders, hey, you gotta wake up at 6 a.m. Hey, don't forget you got a doctor's appointment at 11. You know, those reminders that you take for granted, the ones where you wanna say, Mom, I know. Yeah, those reminders were gone. And that was when I learned. No, I don't know. And I needed to get it together and make some changes. That's where you're forced to either get your life together and create a plan to improve, or you can just end up being that guy or that girl who always shows up late, never gets enough sleep, never finishes anything, isn't accountable for their actions, and doesn't have their priorities straight. I didn't want to be that guy. So there I was, being faced with this exact reality, and we're talking about me, someone who was already disciplined, someone who already had their priorities straight. I already wanted to excel in life, but it's easy to be like that when you're under the constant supervision of your parent. And the moment you're away from all of that, you want to let loose a little bit, you know? You want to live life on the edge. You want to take risks you've never got to take before. Like staying up so late that you only get a couple of hours of sleep before school or work, or partying super late and skipping class. So I did take those risks, and eventually I got back into a corner where I had to face where I was heading versus where I said I wanted to be. All that freedom I said I wanted was a much bigger responsibility than I thought it was. And you might not think it's a big responsibility now, but I promise you it is. The thing I had a hard time realizing was that constant layer of protection I had from my parents always being there was something I was so used to that when it wasn't there anymore, I became forgetful, complacent, and somewhat irresponsible. And you can't be like that, especially if you're someone who wants to improve themselves. Now, I moved out at a younger age than most people did, so you might not see those exact same challenges that I did. Or if you do, you'll probably face the same things, but just to a lesser degree. But when it's completely on you, that's a whole new level of ownership you have to take for everything. You can't say, oh, I didn't know, or I wasn't ready, I didn't get enough sleep, because none of that is an excuse. Because you are now responsible for everything that takes place in your life, whether you like it or not. Remember, you wanted this. Those four words used to haunt me, especially when I faced something difficult. I remember the sleepless nights of taking care of something that I procrastinated on and then going to school or work the next day. That sucked. It especially sucks when you realize you don't get to go home with your parents who are already paying the bills, already have food on the table for you, and probably wouldn't have even let you procrastinate in the first place, because it would have kept reminding you so much. So what I'm saying is I had to man up and realize I wasn't a kid anymore. I had to think different, so the set of habits I ended up creating for myself ended up enhancing my productivity, my life, and my earning potential. I started to move different. I started waking up at 6 a.m. and getting a workout in before anybody was awake. I started getting assignments done week in advance. I started to take the lead on projects. I started challenging myself, and when something didn't work out, I made adjustments instead of complaining about how hard life is. When I got my first full-time job, I went through the ringer, both mentally and physically. Mom and Dad couldn't protect me from that. That experience built me up and exposed me to the shady activities that can and will happen in the work world. I got to test my mental toughness that I know for a fact I wouldn't have taken it to if I was working that job while still living with my parents. If I did, I'd be like, screw it. I live with my parents. I'll just get an easier, less demanding job where the people are a little nicer, where it's not such a challenge. It's not like it's going to affect me because I don't have to pay any bills. See, the layer of protection you have at your parents' house is so overwhelmingly comfortable that you decide to stay in your comfort zone and inhibit your growth as a human being for as long as you want to stay comfortable. And that is something I can't stand. Forget about the fact that you have limits on how long you can be out. Forget that you're told what you can and can't do and how you get lectured constantly. That's nothing compared to the real consequences you face when you decide to stay with your parents for a prolonged amount of time in your adult life. By doing that, I wholeheartedly believe that you're delaying experiences that are absolutely necessary to go through as an adult, good or bad. That's choosing to stay blind to certain life experiences that you need to go through to get to the next level. You must go through these things. Your parents went through it. That's how they're able to watch over you. And that's also how they're able to anticipate what you might go through. They can't protect you forever. And here's the kicker. They don't want to. I can guarantee you, if you're over 20 years old and you still live with your parents, they cannot wait for you to get out the house. See, there's a certain level of respect you get from your parents as an adult once you move out. When you demonstrate to them that you can live a good, successful life without them, without having to call them up for any money, when you're financially stable and fully responsible, where you don't constantly need to be reminded of the simple things you need to do, the more that you have, the more respect you get from them as an adult. The longer you live with your parents, the more the amount of respect they build for you starts to stagnate. I mean, think about it, bro. You're in their house. You have to ask their permission to adjust the thermostat. You have to play by their rules. You have to do chores for them when they want you to do them. You have to answer to them when you mess up. And you know that. So how do you expect them to fully respect you as an independent man or woman when you don't fully have your stuff together? How can you possibly respect a person 100% as an adult when you're asking them, hey, why haven't you taken the trash out yet? Why haven't you cut the grass yet? You can't, bro. See, if you get asked those questions, that's basically saying you really don't have your stuff together because you can't even manage your time well enough to do the few things they ask you to do around the house. So how can they expect you to handle the struggles and the challenges that life is going to hit you with? They won't tell you that, but it's true. You ever seen parents that have grown kids? Do you see how differently they act towards the one who moved out and is doing their own thing compared to the one who still lives at home? You ever see how often they lecture the kid who still lives with them compared to the one who moved out? I've experienced it. My friends experienced it. I'm telling you, bro, this is not a popular topic. Not a lot of people talk about this. But moving out, getting your life together, straightening up your priorities, and getting your money right is how you get your parents to respect you as an adult because they know that you don't have to rely on them anymore. And when you actually get in a position where you can help your parents when they need you, that's where you want to be. That tells them that you learned a little something growing up, that you appreciate them and you're going to pay it forward even if they don't need your help. I send money to my mom every month, and it's purely because I want to and because I'm in a position to do so. Do you know how good it feels to not have to ask your parents for money, but instead you're giving them money? That's how you know you're doing something right. See, if you have a job and you're still living with your parents, it's not the same if you send them money every month because it's seen as you helping out with the bills. But when you do it from another city, another state, where you're not even responsible for helping out with the bills, that is cold. You straight up won't be able to do that if you don't have drive, which is the absolute number one attribute I got from moving out of my parents' house. That rhymed. My drive is absolutely insane because I know what I want to accomplish, where I want to be, and who I want to be in the future. And I know that absolutely no one is responsible for getting me there except for me. I know that no one's going to save me, especially if I'm sitting around all day being lazy, letting life pass me by. I've got to take matters into my own hands, and I don't know that I ever would have realized that if I never moved out. Those are the types of lessons you don't experience until you're out on your own, in the real world, where someone straight up tells you, oh well, oh, that's tough. Whose fault is that? You know, words that tell you like, man, that sucks, I feel for you, but I really don't care about your problems. Those experiences can either make you weak or they can turn you into the person you were meant to be. Because last time I checked, no one is obligated to help you through your problems, especially when you realize most of your problems come from your decisions. I mean, for me, it was stressful and liberating at the same time. I felt an immense amount of pressure to do my best at everything at all times. I felt like there were eyes always on me. I felt like I had to prove something to the world because perception is extremely important and it actually has a lot to do with your success in life. When you're living at your parents' house throughout all these experiences, you know you have them to fall back on. But I had already moved out and I was too prideful, too stubborn to move back in with my parents. I wasn't willing to deal with that level of shame. I decided I'd rather go through the turmoil and stress that life has to offer if that meant it would build me up as a person and make me stronger, tougher, smarter. That means I can add value to others in the future. That means I can go through trial and error, suffer alone, and make adjustments and go through those growing pains that no one else sees without having to worry about getting anyone else's input. Because one thing I know for a fact is that the input from others can greatly hinder your success in life. You know how you don't really need to say anything to your parents for them to sense that something ain't right? Well, I think if my parents saw what I went through at my last job, like if I lived with them through all that, I think they would have urged me to quit. And I probably would have done it too. But if I did, I never would have seen what the other side of that struggle looked like, and I probably would never would have made this YouTube channel. And I have to admit, that experience, even as horrible as it felt at the time, is actually a big reason as to why I am where I am today. When you get your own place, when you move out of your parents' house, the freedom is nice. You can have company over whenever you want, you can live by your own rules, you can walk around with no clothes on. But most importantly, you can become the ultimate version of yourself that can only be unlocked once you've been tested to see what you're made of. That's why you need to move out of your parents' house. Anyways, that's the video for today. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Reggie Bryant, and this channel is all about personal finance and personal growth so you can control you, control your finances, and control your life. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video. Don't forget to like and subscribe and share this video. Stay cold.